Keene research polling out today reveals that 86% approval for expanding background checks on would-be gun buyers. But as you saw, gun sellers are willing to break even existing laws in some cases. We wanted to get the National Rifle Association's take on Martin's report and the push for greater background checks. So joining me tonight, NRA President David Keene. So David, in the story we just saw, the CNN producer very easily obtained those weapons at gun shows without showing any identification. He could have been a criminal, could have had a criminal background. Why shouldn't he have to undergo a background check to buy those weapons?
Well, if they're private sales, as you know, under the law, you don't have to. But private sales and gun shows are not the source. I mean, the FBI has done many studies on this, and they're not really the source of guns for criminals. The current system doesn't work very well, and we think it needs to be fixed.
My question is, somebody seeing that would say, might say, why shouldn't a person, I mean, our producer could have been a criminal. It could have been anybody. Well, nobody even asked for an ID. Why shouldn't he have to undergo a background check, whether it's a private sale, whether it was from a dealer?
Well, I think the question is, when you're dealing with fundamental rights, the question is, first of all, if you're going to put a burden and a restriction on those rights, what do you get from it? Is there empirical evidence that while you say he might have been a criminal, is there empirical evidence that a lot of criminals get firearms at gun shows? The answer to that question is there is not.
But by your own admission,
that is not a source.
Right, I understand.
That is not a source of many firearms that are used in crimes.
But by your own admission, the current background checks that exist have caught thousands of people, more than 10,000 people who have lied on their background checks. And part of the point that the NRA has made, and I think it's an effective point, is those people should be prosecuted for lying on the background checks. They're able to walk out the door. They're not being prosecuted. So why not extend background checks? And just logic tells you, you would catch even more people lying and cheating.
That would be true if, in fact, all of these people caught were lying and were criminals. Many of those people were not prohibited. There were false positives, as they call them. There were people that had their names were confused with somebody else's. There were mistakes. The system didn't work very well. Because what we've suggested is that before you run, you ought to walk.
I don't know what that means.
Before you start dumping millions of more transactions into this system, you ought to fix the system so it works.
I just don't get the logic of saying, well, the system's not perfect, therefore we should allow people to buy guns in all these other ways without checking who they are. I mean, again, in that piece, our producer could have been anybody with a criminal background and walk out with an arsenal of weapons that are not traceable.
He could have walked out on the streets of Washington, D.C. and bought a gun.
Well, not quite as easily as he could have right there.
Illegal guns are available, and there are people who will sell them to him. You know that, and I know that, and every criminal knows it.
That's like saying a murderer doesn't obey murder laws, so we shouldn't have any murder laws.
We shouldn't worry. No, I'm not saying that. But what you're saying is we shouldn't worry about the fact that all of these people who have committed felonies are not being prosecuted.
No,
I'm saying
we should worry about that, and I've agreed with you.
You know, it isn't enough to say, yes, it should be done.
You're making up my argument.
It has the laws. It has the people. It's identified the criminals. It could prosecute them.
Right.
Instead of doing that, they say, let's have another law.
I just don't understand why it's either or. I don't understand why you can't do both.
I think you do things in an orderly way.
Yeah, but when kids are dying and people are being shot needlessly and people are committing suicide with weapons at a high rate, isn't time of the essence rather than trying to do everything orderly?
The thing that we've talked about from the very beginning in all of this discussion is that if you're going to deal with gun crime, you deal with gun criminals. And if we're not dealing with them now, what makes us think that if we pass another law that has tremendous effects on innocent people, that we're going to prosecute more gun criminals?
But how do you know everyone buying a gun at a gun show is an innocent person? How do you know everyone buying a gun from their relative is an innocent person, or buying a gun from their friend in the back of a car is an innocent person, unless you do a background check?
Well, you know, most firearm sales, most private sales, there have been studies that show maybe 3 or 4% of them are arm's length sales, where you don't know the kind of sale that you showed there in your tape. Most of them are, in fact, family.
Well, you know what? Families sell guns to people
most
who shouldn't
them
have
them. Most of are friends.
Right. Friends are stupid.
Are you suggesting?
Yeah, plenty of friends sell guns to
even the President of the United States even the President of the United States, when he talked about universal background checks, was going to exempt families. So you think they should be included as well?
I don't know. I'm asking the question, but I'm asking the question for viewers who do believe that. I don't take a position on this one way or another, but if friends can sell their car to a friend and have to file paperwork for it, I guess my question is, why shouldn't that be done with guns as well? And I know driving is not a right.
I don't think that there's a constitutional amendment or a part of the Bill of Rights that gives you a fundamental right to an automobile.
David Keene, I always appreciate you having you on.